Still with China, the country's top legislative body is set to meet from November 4 to 8. State news agency Xinhua said draft laws and amendments covering mineral resources, energy, and maritime issues are among those to be discussed. But there was no mention of measures that Finance Minister Lan Fo-an flagged earlier this month when he said China would significantly increase government debt and prop up consumption and the property sector. Investors have been disappointed by the lack of details on the size and timing of recently announced bumper stimulus measures. In local corporate headlines, Robinson's retail holding sees a 29% jump in its third quarter profit. This triples its nine-month net income to 7.8 billion pesos. The increase is due in part to a one-time gain from the merger of Robinson's Bank into BPI. Contributions from the company's food and drugstore segments also help boost sales. And Tanduay Distillers sells its 94.75% stake in its ethanol unit, the Asian Alcohol Corporation, or AAC. It was sold to Prior Holdings, another shareholder, for an undisclosed amount. The Lushutan Group had been trying to unload since restarting AAC, the latest attempt being the failed sale to Victoria's Milling in 2022. Let's check on European markets first. European markets are swinging between gains and losses, weighed by weak earnings from automakers. The German DAX is barely in the green, up just by 12 points, despite data showing business morale in Europe's biggest economy rose for the first time in 4 months in October.
We'll have to wait and see whether it really is a turnaround. But it basically shows that we're at least not in a recessionary dynamic in which things are going down faster and faster, but rather in a kind of stagnation of the economy. The dominant topic in the boardrooms is certainly the uncertainty about future economic development. The political environment is very much part of this, and companies are naturally worried about protectionism. They expect a burden overall, especially if Donald Trump wins, because he has announced that he wants to impose high tariffs.
As for Wall Street, futures are pointing to a positive open as a dip in Treasury yields provided some relief. The major indices, however, are on pace for weekly losses, which would snap their six-week winning streaks. Asian markets ended the week on a mixed note. The Nikkei 225 shed 0.6% as Japan buckles down for this Sunday's general election and looked ahead to the central bank's policy meeting next week. The meeting comes as data showed core inflation in the capital, Tokyo, fell below the BOJ's 2% target for the first time in 5 months to 1.8%. Here at home, the local bourse snapped a two-day losing streak, but still posted a weekly loss of 1.4%.
Earnings will be driving the index in the next couple of weeks or so, as well as the upcoming U.S. elections that could create some uncertainty, which might bring about some additional volatility to the index. Although what we've been seeing lately is that we're seeing a bit of profit taking. Definitely, they've already been stepping in. Year to date, we're at a net foreign buy of 4.1 billion.
As for the Philippine peso, it crossed the 58 to the dollar level. The local currency closed at 58.32 against the greenback Friday. That's a near three-month low as the dollar strengthened on falling expectations of aggressive Fed rate cuts and political uncertainty ahead of the November U.S. elections.